The NBA draft process is all about evaluating talent, and players know that teams make it their business to judge with a discerning eye. That's why over the years, even the highest draft picks have hit the gym to work on their game.
Six, good shot. Come on, be an all-star. Let's go. Be an all-star. Let's go.
Knowing that if I come in the gym and work hard every day, I'll be a decent player in the NBA, hopefully.
Crush, let's go.
For UNC Tar Heel Harrison Barnes, a gym in Miami is where he set about making himself more of a finished product.
Come on, finish, finish!
It's a great experience to just kind of start getting in shape because you know you're going to go through a draft, combine. You'd be in tremendous shape for that, and then team workouts. I mean, they're going to try to bury you, you know, just try to see where you are mentally, see where you are condition-wise. Now's a great time, just kind of that down period in between school getting out and pre-draft for people to get in shape.
At North Carolina, Barnes was known as a dynamic scorer, but he realizes there are holes in his game.
We try to work on ball handling, since that's a weakness of mine, just trying to, you know, improve upon that. And obviously we work on shot consistency when fatigued, and then just exploding up, getting by the rim, and just trying to finish strong.
You really can't let it affect you too much. I mean, people are going to say things about you, good or bad. You know, you just have to, you know, be able to play through that.
Come on, get dialed in. Let's go.
That's how I've always approached criticism. It's just a way to fuel me and just propel me to that next step.
Good age, good age. That's the way.
I can't jump as high as everybody else, not as quick as everybody else. There's just things that I was blessed with, but just not as much as other people.
Nice. Last one. Here we go.
And you just have to compensate by just your work ethic.
Good. Very good.
He put in extra time all the time. He'd show up at the gym at 6 a.m. He'd call to get extra shots up. He has such a passion, whether it was before practice, after practice, early in the morning, come back at night.
Can't do much better than that.
But I told him, your passion will allow you to be great.
Up north in Orlando, another ACC star, Austin Rivers, was also sharpening his skills.
Go to work.
What we do here is we just try to work on things that makes me better as a player. And that way, when I go to these workouts, I can, you know, try to dominate and show them what I can do. And there's always that saying, play to your strengths. And we do that here, but we like to play to our weaknesses too. That way, when we go out onto the court or the real deal, you don't have too many weaknesses. Just like quick moves like that. That's why I do all those handling drills. That way, they're forcing me right. I could fake right or I could fake left. It doesn't matter which direction you point me to. You want to be able to do multiple things.
It's like a habit. So if you get in the habit of going strong in practice, you're going to take that same habit into a game.
One of his pet shots is his floater. So that's another thing that we'll really work on.
You just try to get in the paint. Serge Ibaka. Paul Gasol.
What about Dwight Howard? Man, get Dwight.
You got to come in.
Dwight.
Throw it up. That's it.
Austin has always been well-versed in the NBA. His father, Glenn Doc Rivers, was a heady point guard, and now with the Celtics, is considered one of the top coaches in the league.
His whole life has been me in the NBA. That's all he's watched. That's all he's been around.
We got to play the game with force, all right? You got to play the game with force.
He's played against Paul Pierce and all those other guys on our team.
And then I put on like a jersey, T-Mac jersey, or when he coached the Magic, or Paul Pierce jersey or something like that, and I'd come out here and try out all their moves and pretend like I was one of them. Just like that. I would sometimes cut like a sock and put it on my arm like a sleeve and pretend like I was like Tracy McGrady or something like that. And I'd come out here and shoot all my shots. I'd be out here for hours until my mom said I'd come in for bed.
Those backyard dreams led to stardom at Duke University, where Rivers was only the second unanimous ACC Rookie of the Year since the award was introduced in 1976.
He loves the big stage. He hasn't been built that way. It's just who he is. It's his makeup.
Austin might be brimming with confidence, but this draft process has revealed a different side of a man who's seen it all in the NBA.
My dad always tries to play so, you know, the cool dad, the cool coach, who's always relaxed. But when it comes to his kids, he's a normal dad. He gets nervous. He wants the best for him. He wants them to do the best, especially in this situation with me. You know, he's real nervous right now, and he calls me a lot.
That was my dad. Yeah. Yeah, my dad's interrupting my interview.
You know, I'm a coach and a parent. Watching your kids play is hard.
Now people call me Austin. You know, hey, that's Austin Rivers. That's Doc's kid. And eventually, I want to work to a point where people go up to my dad and be like, hey, aren't you Austin's dad? And I know I have a long way to get there, but you know, I feel like with hard work, I think that day will come.